Good morning.
Morning.
Beautiful morning. Welcome to all those who are here this morning, and a special welcome to those who are guests or visiting with us today. And a special welcome to Pastor Tim Scramstead and his family. Pastor Tim is going to fill in for Pastor Sam, who is out with their family, has had the stomach flu. So he was kind of anticipating by today that he probably wouldn't be here. So we thank you for that. We'll open with a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning for bringing us here, for delivering us to a place where we can hear your word, we can learn, we can take it in and to follow. Lord, I ask that you would be with each and every person here this morning, that their minds and their hearts would be open to receive your word. And may the blessings just pour out. Lord, we ask that you would be with us today to keep us all safe as we go through this week, and that the words spoken here would be in our hearts. Lord, I ask this all in Jesus' name. Amen. The only announcement that I have, let me look here. If you notice in your bulletin this morning, there's a new sheet that has all the contact information on it for the council. And you can take a peek through there and see who your council members are, I think you all know, and how to get a hold of them should you need to. Take a peek here. The discipleship series will continue at Pastor Sam and Rachel's home at 6 p.m. on Monday. And anything else on here? Our Wednesday night Lenten soup suppers and Lenten service. And choir practice to follow. Tim.
Just want to remind everybody that this Minnesota has got the presidential primary this Tuesday from 7. The polls are open from 7 to 8. And you'll want to be out there for both, wherever you are, for the Republican or Democrat, if he's not there. But, you need to look where your polling is. And that's where you should be at. So, from 7 on Tuesday, this Tuesday, primary, presidential.
Thank you. Women's Bible prayer time at Tim and Joan's home at 6 p.m. on Thursday. And a women's Bible study on Fridays at 9:30. And let me see. Women's Missionary Federation Spring Rally. Saturday, March 16th, starts at 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. If you're interested, talk to Karen Reitz. Are there any other announcements? Okay. Oh, yeah. Thanks for the reminder. So daylight saving time. Remember to set the clocks. Are we going forward or backward? Forward. All right. So,
I don't see Kay here, but I know there's 2 weeks left that nobody signed up for soup suppers. So, if you're interested in that, you could sign up, help her out. That'd be great.
Anything else? All right. Our opening hymn is When I Survey the Wondrous Cross, page 63 in your red hymnals and 31 in the large print. Scripture reading this morning, the Old Testament lesson is from Isaiah 6, verses 1 through 10. Follow along with your Bibles if you wish. Please rise. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up, and the train of his robe filled the temple. Above him stood a seraphim. Each had six wings. Two he covered his face, and with two he covered his feet, and with two he flew. And one called to another and said, "Holy, holy, holy, this is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory." And the foundations of threshold shook at the voice of him who called, and the house was filled with smoke. And I said, "Woe is me, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of people with unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." And then one of the seraphim flew to me, having in his hand a burning coal that he had taken with tongs from the altar. And he touched my mouth and said, "Behold, this has touched your lips. Your guilt is taken away, and your sin atoned for." And I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send, and who will go for us?" And then I said, "Here I am, send me." And he said, "Go and say to the people, keep on hearing, but do not understand. Keep on seeing, but do not perceive. Make the heart of this people dull, and their ears heavy, and blind their eyes, lest they see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their hearts, and turn and be healed." Our gospel lesson for today is from Luke 4, verses 31 through 37. And he went down to Capernaum, the city of Galilee, and he was teaching them on the Sabbath. And they were astonished in his teaching, and for his word processed authority. And the synagogue was a man who had a spirit of unclean demon, and he cried out with a loud voice, "Ha! What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are. You are the Holy One of God." But Jesus rebuked him, saying, "Be silent, come out of him." And when the demon had thrown him down into their midst, he came out of him, having done him no harm. And they were all amazed and said to one another, "What is this word? For with the authority and the power he commands the unclean spirits," and they came out. And the reports about him went out through every place in the surrounding region. Here ends the readings.
We have our confession of sin, which is an important part of every service as we think about the fact that not just one of us has sinned, but all of us have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. I have confession of sin in my ministerial acts book, and we'll see if that's the same one that you have in your hymnal on page 2. We would confess this together. Almighty God, our Maker and Redeemer, we poor sinners confess to you that we are by nature sinful and unclean, and that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed. Therefore, we flee for refuge to your infinite mercy and ask you, for Christ's sake, grant us forgiveness of all of our sins, and by your Holy Spirit, increase in us true knowledge of you and of your will, and true obedience to your word, to the end that by your grace we may come to eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We find these words that are recorded in the first epistle of John, that if we confess our sins, He, that is Jesus, is faithful and righteous to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. May you believe and trust in the Word of God today. Amen.
Now, prayer and praise time. Do we have any praises or prayers?